Good day, everybody. In this video, I would like to explain how to estimate changes in the vertical stress acting on the soil element when we apply vertical load line. Let's look at this schematic diagram where we have a soil mass, all this soil mass, and we're going to apply this load here. We call it Q, and we typically use it as a stress. So these are the units. And let's just imagine that this Q will be 15 kilonewton per square meters. This is just an example that we're going to do right now. And we know that the soil element is at the depth of about 2 meters. And another thing that we'd like to know is the distance of the soil element from the point of load application. So let's assume that X will be 3 meters. So this is what we need to know to estimate the change in the stress. So that's the value that we're after. What is the practical application? For example, if we're going to build like maybe a pole here and it's a very narrow point load. So we would like to know what will be the changes in the soil mass. There are two ways to solve this problem. I will show you both of them. The first one, we're going to use this equation. And the second one, it will be a graphical solution when we use this graph. Remember that this solution is made for a homogeneous, elastic, and isotropic medium, which soil mass is typically not in real life. But when we talk about very small stresses and application of small stresses to soil mass, in this case, we can assume that, okay, so it can be homogeneous, elastic, and isotropic medium. Okay, so now let's see how we can solve this. I'm going to put the numbers in the formula to estimate change in that vertical stress, delta sigma z. So we're going to put 2 times Q, and we assume it's 15 kilonewton per square meters. Z will be the depth, as we already said, it's going to be 2 in the power of 3, divided by pi. So pi here. And then this x squared, which is 3 meters in the power of 2, plus z in the power of 2, and everything in the power of 2. So this is the formula. According to my calculations, it should be 0.45 kilonewton per square meters. Okay. So that's how we use the formula. Let's see how we can actually use a graphical solution. For example, if you don't remember the formula or don't have it in front of you, you can still solve the problem. So what I did, I rewrote this equation as shown here. And then I use Excel to get this correlation between this component on the left-hand side and the one on the right-hand side. I changed this ratio x over z, and I put it here. And then when I change this x over z for each value starting from 0, 0.51, I calculated this component on the left-hand side, and then I plotted the data. So the data looks like this curve. And then what we're going to use right now, we will see how we can actually use this curve to solve the problem. So we only need to know the ratio x over z, and that will be x is 3 meters in this problem, divided by z is equal to, it's going to be 1.5. So we see where we have 1.5, and it correlates to value of 0.06. So now what we can do is to say that this component on the left-hand side, delta sigma z, is equal Q, which is 15, divided by z, which is 2, and everything is equal to 0.06. And from here, we can find that change in the vertical stress, delta sigma z, will be approximately 0.45, which is exactly the value that we obtain using the formula. That's it for this tutorial. Thanks for watching it. Have a nice day. Bye.